I mean, what it is quite clearly showing today is that we are, the government of the day has to make, you know, tough, decisive, responsible decisions to meet the need of our country and our citizens in difficult times. And what we have at the moment, one of the biggest issues is with regards to how do we fund and support adult social care. And I think what we have now, it's if we don't take decisive action, we've got 5 million people waiting to have health treatment within our National Health Service. If we don't put that extra investment, the 12 billion, the fact is that will be up to 13 million people waiting to get that treatment. So, Adam, what I would say, having heard Rupert and Kirsten, is this. You know, when you're in government, you've got to take decisive, responsible decisions. Rupert said earlier that she disagrees with the principle of national insurance contributions being used to pay for the investment in healthcare. But in 2002, 2003, the Labour government did exactly the same things with regards to national...
Let in Rupert in a moment. Just finish your point, please.
So the point on that. So on that basis, Labour did exactly the same. And with regards to, you know, looking at the alternatives put forward by the Labour Party, we saw the Shadow Health Secretary who said on the, you know, the 18th of July, when asked specifically on TV, would you support specific funding for adult social care tax rises, you know, if it's ring-fenced for healthcare? He said, why would we oppose that? Because we want to see more money going into healthcare and social care. So with that being the case, you know, previously we've had governments, Labour government, Royal Commission, green paper, nothing done. Decisive decisions need to be taken in the best interest of our citizens in the most responsible way. And what I would say to Kirsten, you know, with regards to the situation in Scotland, we have the situation from the Audit Office of Scotland saying there needs to be urgent need for, with regards to investment in adult social care. So with that being the case, this extra initiative would mean 2.2 billion extra for Scotland and its people with regards to health and social care. I think that's only a good thing for Scotland.
Thank you very much indeed for that. Well